sorry, Mrs. Benson, but there's nothing more we can do. We've tried everything, but there just seems to be no change.
Please, ma. Let's try harder. I mean, we need to put more effort to salvage the situation.
We've done everything, but there's just no change. I suggest you take him to another school. Better still, a special school. Because as for here, I'm sorry, it's just not working. Sorry. Suggest you take him to another school. Better still, a special school.
I'm counting down to another day.
God, why me? I have been a faithful Christian. Did you have to put this on me?
Somebody please help me.
I swear I am tired. This has lingered for far too long.
Take one easy. Look at what we've got to deal with. Is this some kind of minor problem we can just wish away anytime we like? The boy has been in primary one for 6 years. For 6 good years, I have flushed money down the drain trying to take care of, a boy that is abnormal.
Femi, please, stop referring to our only son as abnormal. What is that now?
Then if you have a better word to describe what is wrong with him, you tell me, because from where I'm sitting, he has abnormal screaming all over him. Mrs. Chukuma.
Good evening, Femi. Hope I wasn't interrupting anything.
Oh, not at all.
Good evening.
Hi, Emma. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
How's it work?
Fine, how's your family?
Oh, they're fine.
Oh,
in fact, that's what brings me here. Oh, Tucci's really? Birthday is on Saturday, and we're hoping Junior could join us.
That won't be possible. In fact, Junior traveled and he's not around for a while.
Oh, that's a shame. Anyway, I hope sometime when we have another party, he'll be able to join
us. Oh, sure, why not? Sure, of course, he will.
I think that's the suitcase that just fell off the water. I was just trying to put things together before you came in, so let me just quickly go on there.
Let me leave you there to continue what you're doing.
Oh, okay.
So you guys have a good evening.
Thank you so much for the invitation. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
You do have a great night. Good night.
Okay, bye.
We'll try another school tomorrow. Of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge.
Junior, has there been any improvement?
Auntie, no. In fact, he was pulled out of school just last week, and that's like the third school he has been to in 4 months.
Three schools in 4 months?
In fact, Auntie, I am tired. I'm just tired of it all. I'm tired.
It's not like we've not done our best for Junior, but the thing is, Junior cannot remain in a school for too long. It's the same complaints from the teachers, from his friends, the same thing. He does not participate in any school activities. He's kind of detached. Sometimes he cries and laughs for no particular reason. It's disturbing, really.
What are you people doing about this issue?
Auntie, how else are we supposed to try when we don't even know what is wrong with him?
Have you tried seeking spiritual help?
Spiritual help? What for?
That is my problem with you people sometimes. You are so entrenched in your modern ways that you ignore the effect of the spiritual on the physical. Don't you know that some of these people you see with things happening to them and not by ordinary hand?
Auntie, so what are you proposing?
I know a prophet in my church. I'm sure he will be willing to find out what is wrong and pray for Junior.
The prophet?
He's a very powerful man of God, and he sees vision. By the time he prays for Junior, you will begin to see results.
Auntie, please. Please, just help us talk to him. Let's see if he can find a solution to our problem.
No problem. Don't worry. I will talk to him and then I'll get back to you. Okay?
Fine. Thank you
very much, Auntie. We'll appreciate anything he will do to help us. Thank you so much.
It's all right.
Thank you.
Let me be on my way, man.
Thank you. Thanks for coming.
Bye-bye.
Femi, our son is not going to see this
prophet. I am the man in this house and my decision is final. If that boy needs spiritual help, and that's what he's going to get.
Femi, that boy needs medical assessment.
Which we have tried in the past and to no avail.
because we haven't been going to the right place.
See, listen, I am tired of roaming around the place, paying school fees and paying medical bills. Listen, if a prophet is going to bring us out of this embarrassment, I'm all in for it.
Oh, so since when has spending money become
important? Considering the fact that you're not the one paying the money, if a prophet is going to bring us out of this embarrassment, I'm in for it.
Listen, Femi, this is our son we're talking about here. And I will not sit back and fold my arms and watch you destroy his life.
Yeah, we lie. That is why we need a prophet.
Femi. It's not going to work. Prophet is not going to work in this house, Femi.
Stay still. Come on, write. Don't make this so difficult for me, Junior, please. Hello? Yes? Sandra!
Thank you. It's so good to see you.
You look good. I'm sad at the same time. What's wrong?
I'm fine.
Junior, how are you doing?
Junior, this is Auntie Sandra, you remember? And how long has it been like this?
Well, as long as I can remember.
It changes school faster than I can even catch a breath. The father has abandoned him for me ever since I chased the prophet out of the house.
Are you kidding me, the prophet?
Okay, that's a story for another day.
Let me see. I have reasons to believe that Junior has autism.
Okay, what is that? How do I explain this to you now?
Okay, it goes this way. Autism is a complex disorder of the brain development. Now, these disorders are characterized in varying degrees by difficulties in social interaction, verbal and non-verbal reasoning, and then repetitive behaviors,
like doing the same thing over and over again. God forbid. God forbid.
What?
Ama, I'm sorry, the signs are so blurry.
I told you I worked to the health sector way back in the States. You know, what I did, moving that toy from one position to the other, was a test to confirm my suspicion that I was right. Now, one of the signs of autism is resistance to change. They keep something at a position and you move it, they react negatively, like they... Oh, come on now. It's not that bad. See, I mean, there are places where you could take him to. I know somewhere, a friend of mine works there, and I hear they're very good.
Seems far away, but you're still here. How can I erase the pain away? How can I change it and bring it back the way it should be? Say, someday we're gonna make it a better world.
Only if we take, step by step.
Only if we work through the light.
When did you call me?
Just last week. Sorry, I should have called earlier, but I've just been so busy.
I can imagine.
Hello.
Hello. Welcome to our school.
Thank you.
Actually, this is my cousin Ama. She needs your help.
The lady you spoke of the other time about her son, right?
Yes. My cousin here tells me that you have a school that can deal with my case.
You have come to the right place. I'll take you around the center. I will now go in and see my director.
Thank you.
You're welcome to Patrick's.
Thank you.
How may we help you?
Oh, well, madam, I have a son. He's 10 years old and he still acts like a toddler. As a matter of fact, my husband has stopped paying his bills. We
been changing schools severally from one school to the other and no improvement. And at this time right now, I am completely confused. I don't know what to do.
Does he display any odd behavior that you're worried about? Does he rock? Does he flap? Does he play in isolation? If you put him with a group of children, would he retract and play on his own? Does he talk at all?
No, he doesn't. Well, yes, as a matter of fact, when he was much younger, he used to utter words like dad, water, but as he grew older, he lost all of that.
Does he answer to his name?
No, he doesn't. In fact, when spoken to, he just stays there. He doesn't respond to you at all.
Okay. Have you had any hearing tests done on him?
Oh, yes. Actually, we did a test and it came out well. You know, and I realized that whenever we want to play his favorite cartoon for him to watch on TV, even when you reduce the volume to the barest minimum, he still could pick and then he runs towards the TV.
Mrs. Benson, from all said, I think your son has signs of autism. But we have to do a more thorough assessment using the M-chart tool to help us know where his strengths are and then use that to draw up a plan for him that will then lead us to the road of recovery.
Please tell me, madam, can my son have a normal life? Can he? He's my only son. I don't know. Is there any hope for
yes,
him?
That's why we're here. There's a boy here at the center who is 18 years old. He came to us when he was about 17. And we started to teach him how to play the piano. And in 6 months, he learned how to play the piano. Now you can give him any key and he will play it beautifully.
Wow, that's incredible.
Amazing. It's not a death sentence.
So he can live a normal life, like live a life like every other child.
I don't see why not. All you need is love and patience, and you can teach him every skill he needs to learn.
Thank you so much, madam. Sandra, I'm so grateful. You don't know how relieved I am right now. I'm 10 years old.
It's okay.
I've been suffering for 10 years.
It's okay.
Thank you so much. This means a lot.
You're welcome. Do our best.
Okay.
Okay, now, don't come and try it, Femi. Femi, I want you to wait. Let me play it, Femi. Let's play it now, let's play it. Let's play it. Let's play it now, Femi. This is Do, Re, Mi, Fa, So, La, Ti, Do. Okay, let's try it now. Try it now. Can you try it though? Okay, for me.
Fa, So, La. 5. Now, play do, play so, play mi, play la, play do. Good boy. Clap yourself. High five. Okay, let's go now. Mi, mi.
Nice to see you again.
Thank you.
And this must be Junior's daddy.
Yes, this is Femi.
Nice to meet you, sir.
Thank you so much. Yes. I must confess you've got a very wonderful center here.
Thank you very much. We try to make the environment conducive for the children and child friendly so they can move around and then have a good day. Have you seen the great improvement in Junior?
Oh, of fact, tremendous. Very tremendous one.
I'm glad. Here comes Junior. Hi, Junior.
When you close your eyes, you see the picture that you want to see. Then when you open up your mind, it comes the way that you really feel. How do I know? But then the story's been told. Why should I think and want to believe? How do I feel when you show the real thing? Oh, don't matter to me, 'cause I know I made it. True to storm, I made it.
The first thing you would notice is that the child is not talking, or the child spoke for a while and then lost speech.
My name is Grace Oduni. I'm a parent of one of the children in Patrick School. His name is Toby Oduni. We discovered the problem when Toby was a little bit above 2 years old. He wasn't speaking like any other child.
Usually when the children are not talking, the parents tend to want to take them to the doctor, the or their pediatrician, or even sometimes the school notices that this child is not talking, should be talking at this particular age.
He wasn't talking at 2. He was unable to talk. He did every other thing at the right time. But we were like, why is this boy not talking by 2 years old?
You find the child flapping. You find the child rocking or spinning or holding onto an object and looking at that object in a particular manner, waving it. Those are some of the behaviors that you can see that would indicate that, oh, there's something wrong with this child. You find some of them walking on their tiptoes, and sometimes they don't like being touched, or they are overly sensitive to sound. You find them covering their ears, or sometimes shutting their eyes to light. So those are some of the signs. It's not one thing, it's a combination of signs. The child has to have a sign in the social skill unit, meaning that the child is not playing with other children, tends to play alone. Has to have one in communication, that is speech, talking, verbal or non-verbal, facial expressions. And the child also has to have one in behavior, odd behavior, hyperactivity, flapping, looking from the corner of the eyes. It's a combination of all these things that really tells you that, oh, there's something wrong with this child.
When he came, the city spam was very short, but now it's better. Then the way he relates to people, I think it's better now.
Diet, in the sense that sometimes, because autism is a neurobiological disorder, meaning that there's something in the biology of the child that is different, and there's something in the neuro, that is the brain, that is different.
diet goes a long way, because sometimes when you change the diet of the child, you find that the child starts to improve. Wheat sometimes affects the gut of the child with autism. They have what we call the leaky gut, meaning that they have holes in some of their intestines. And sometimes, if you give the right diet, those holes can heal themselves. But if you give the wrong diet, like wheat, what happens is wheat goes into the bloodstream of the child and turns into what we call opium. And if opium gets into the brain, you see the child spacing out, jumping from place to place, being hyperactive. And these are some of the things that we say parents should take their children off wheat-based products, like flour, like also casein, like milk products. We also have sugar, which is also one of the things that the children react to. For a child with autism, the first thing you need to do is please bring out that child. Do not let that child be stigmatized against. So what parents tend to have, what we call shame culture. We have the shame culture. They don't want people to know that they have a child that is different. Meanwhile, there's nothing wrong with a child with autism. If you work with that child at an early age, if you start early, you will definitely move along a particular path. All children are not the same. We also have those that are very low functioning, those that have autism combined with mental retardation, and those that have loss of skills and eventually don't gain skills. So it depends on the level at which the child is at. We also have those on the high functioning end. We have those that function very well in different settings, like in maths and science, they are of high intellect. We also have the savants, that is those that are excellent at a particular skill, but still have challenges in other areas. So it's what we call a spectrum. So children can be anywhere on that spectrum. But all we know is that the earlier you start working with a child, the better the child will turn out. And therapy is the only thing that can help. You cannot use medication unless the child has what we call attention deficit disorder, and it cannot be controlled by diet or by therapy. Then parents tend, or the doctor can recommend a particular medication for that child. But with autism itself, there is no medication that can cure it. You must try the diet and you must do therapy. You must do speech therapy, occupational therapy, behavioral modification, music therapy. Music is fantastic. I mean, sometimes you talk to a child on the spectrum and the child doesn't answer to his name, and you sing his name, and the child responds. Or sometimes you are trying to get the attention of the child. The child is not looking at you, you're looking all over the place, and you start a rhyme. And the face of the child lights up. It gives you a smile, trying to tell you that, oh, I understand. Music is something that I know the children really, really respond to. A lot of the children. It's not a death sentence. Agbolade, my son, is in year 9 in a regular school system. And he goes to school like a regular child, does his things like a regular child. And if I don't tell you, you won't know he's on the spectrum. They have good skills in hand skills and in music and in art. Depending on where that child is turning towards, you cannot really pick out a particular thing. But because their brain likes order, you can get them into jobs like stacking at the supermarket, arranging stuff on the shelf. You can get them into doing putting things in boxes, arranging in boxes and boxing. Anything that has to do with routine, they work very well with it.
My name is Emeka Aubere.
I can cut. I can do thread.
Thread for the mop making, arranging of the thread for the mop making.
I can cut wood. I can nail wood.
I know how to cut a wood with saw. When I'm cutting, I just put my mind there.
There is hope with autism. It's not a hopeless situation. And the earlier we start with the children, the better they get. So early intervention is definitely key. And there is light even inside the tunnel.
My name is Oriafe Oluwa Osisami. I'm 21 years old.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place could be brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you find there's no need, right? And this place could be there's no better sorrow.
We made it.